Hi, everyone. Welcome to Dance the Story with Pittsburgh Ballet Theatre. My name is Marcella Day, and I'm a teaching artist in our education department. Today, we will be reading and dancing our way through The Nutcracker, a classic holiday ballet. Let's start by meeting our characters. First, in this light pink box, we have Marie. After that, right here in this darker pink box, we have the nephew, but also the Nutcracker. Down here in the corner, we have Drosselmeyer. In this corner right here, we have the Rat King. Oh, I don't like rats too much, do you? And then next, in the center, we have our Sugar Plum Fairies. Now, friends, last time I read a story with you, we played a little game where we had to do a different movement with each character. Let's play that game again. For Marie, I want everyone to pretend they're holding a doll, just like Marie. Can you do it with both hands? I can only do it with one since I'm holding a book, but I want you to do it with two hands. Next, we have the nephew and the Nutcracker. Do you think those two characters could be similar? I think so. I think we should hold up our sword the way the Nutcracker is. Ready? Let's try. Good, everyone. Next, we have Drosselmeyer. And Drosselmeyer is very magical. Do you think we can pretend to use our magic powers? Sprinkle them all over. Good, everyone. Next, we have the Rat King. And the Rat King looks kind of scary. Do you think you can show me your best rat paws? Good. And next, we have the beautiful Sugar Plum Fairy. Dancers, do you think you can do a movement that makes you feel beautiful? I feel beautiful when I move my arms. You can move them up and down. Ready? So that means every time we hear these names, we have to do the movement that matches them. Are you ready to read the story? Let's see. Act one. It's Christmas Eve in Pittsburgh, over 100 years ago. The Stahlbaum family is having a party at their house. Inside, Marie, hold your Nutcracker doll, is reading a book of Christmas stories. Her parents give her two special gifts because she is growing up, a beautiful scarf and a pair of pointe shoes. Outside, Drosselmeyer use those magic powers. And his nephew, show me your sword, unload Christmas gifts for the party. The nephew has to wear a mask because he has been cursed by the Rat King. The mask scares some people. The party begins. Drosselmeyer is a magician and does lots of magic tricks for the guest. He makes dolls come to life and dance. That's so cool. Drosselmeyer gives Marie a wooden Nutcracker doll. Marie shows it to her little brother, Fritz. He grabs it from her and he breaks it. And Marie starts to cry. I would cry too, friends. Drosselmeyer and his nephew try to fix the Nutcracker for her. Marie sees that the nephew is kind, even though others are scared of him. I think that was very nice of her. Don't you think so, friends? After much fun and more dancing, the party ends. The guests leave and the Stahlbaum family goes to bed. But Marie has forgotten her nutcracker. So she tiptoes downstairs to find him. But Marie is not alone. As the clock strikes midnight, giant rats and mice skitter after her. She is so scared and she faints. Drosselmeyer appears. He magically makes everything grow. The toys, the presents, even the Christmas tree. Marie wakes up and can't believe what she sees. The Nutcracker doll has come to life. Suddenly, giant rats and mice return with the scary Rat King. Ooh. They start a battle with the Nutcracker and the toy soldiers. The Rat King knocks the Nutcracker to the floor, but Marie takes off her shoe and she starts to hit the Rat King. His rat friends carry him away. That was very brave of her. Marie runs over to help the Nutcracker. The Nutcracker takes off his mask and she sees that he is actually the nephew and also a Nutcracker prince. So the Nutcracker and the nephew are the same person. Well, friends, the prince invites Marie on a journey. First, they go to the snowy forest where the snow king and queen dance a beautiful pas de deux. Friends, can you say pas de deux? Good, that is French for a dance for two. The snowflakes whirl and swirl and dance for the prince and Marie. Soon, the prince and Marie arrive in the land of enchantment. They are greeted by the sugar plum fairy and her cavalier. Marie and the prince dance a waltz with the flowers. Look at these beautiful dancing flowers, everyone. Then people from faraway lands dance for Marie and the prince. Let's see who we have. We have Spanish dancers who move boldly and with flair. We have Chinese dancers with curling ribbons and a dragon. We have Arabian dancers who are very strong and flexible. We have Russian dancers who jump high into the air. We have shepherdesses that dance with their cute little sheep and a cart full of clowns that dance too. Then, the sugar plum fairy and her cavalier dance a pas de deux. Remember, pas de deux means a dance for two. Finally, all of the characters join together and put on a final performance. But Marie can't find the prince. The land of enchantment starts to fade away. Marie wakes up in her room She wonders, was it all just a dream? And friends, that is the end of our story. Can we clap for the story? Now we are going to have a ballet class. So let's go ahead, let's put our hands on our hips, stand with our feet together, stand up nice and tall, and let's listen for our ballet music. Ready, stand up nice and tall, feet together. Let's open our feet like a book and close our feet. Good. Open our feet, stay here. This is first position. Now we are going to practice our pliés. Good, plié means to bend. And now we are going to rise to relevé. Good, dancers. Lower your feet back down. Make your feet a little bigger for second position. Let's plie. Good. Once again, rise up to releve. Lifting up nice and tall. Good, friends. Lower those heels. Bring your feet back to first position. Let's pick up our basket of flowers and let's move our arms. Friends, can you show me how you like to move your arms? Our tendu. So let's put our hands back on our hips. Tendu means to stretch. So let's stretch our leg out and in. Out and in. Out and in. Out. Now let's try going to the front. Tendu front. Close first. Front. Good. Now let's try the other leg. Tendu and close. Legs are straight. Good. To the front. Good, dancers. And finish. Now, dancers, let's move on to our passes. So when we balance in passe, we bring our toe to our knee and balance. We bring our toe to our knee and balance. Ready, friends? Let's try it without music. Bring your toe to your knee. Closing first. Good, everyone. Bring your toe to your knee. Closing first. Good again. Bring your toe to your knee. Closing first. Bring your toe to your knee. Closing first. Good, everyone. Now, let's finish off ballet class with sautés. Sauté means to jump. So we are going to plié, sauté in the air with two straight legs, plié, and stretch. Ready? Let's try it with music. Ready, we plié, sauté, plié, stretch, plié, sauté, plié, and stretch, plié, sauté, plié, stretch, plié, sauté, plié. Good, dancers, we plié, sauté, point those toes in the air, plié, sauté, plié, and stretch, plié, sauté, plié, stretch, plié. Sauté, plié, and finish. Now, we are going to learn a new jump today. This jump is called pas de chat. Can you all say pas de chat?
Good. Padishah means the cat's step. So for this one, hands are on your hips, feet are in first position. You are going to use your right leg to bring it up to passe, flat, up to passe, to first. That's all it is, except you jump with it. So let's try it again. Just the passe, 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 and close. Good, let's try it again. Ready? Standing up tall. Here we go. Let's passe, passe, and close. Now, let's try it with the jump. So we have to plie, passe, passe, and stretch. Let's try it again. Ready? Plie, passe, passe, and stretch. Make it really quick. Go up, up. Let's try it again. Hands on your hips. Ready? Plie, passe, passe, and close. Good, everyone. Now, remember that step because you will need it for your Nutcracker dance. Now, we are going to learn the mouse dance from the Nutcracker. Do you remember when Marie was sneaking down stairs to get her Nutcracker and all the mice came out to play? Well, we are going to pretend that we are those mice today, okay? So, let's go ahead. Let's start with our feet together. When the music comes on, you'll hear 12 chimes. Those chimes represent a clock telling us that it is midnight, okay? So with those chimes, I want you to see your 12 best mice poses, okay? So think of how a mouse would stand. Do you think a mouse would be really sweet? Do you think a mouse would be kind of scary? Think of the mouse you want to be, and I want to see your 12 poses, okay? Once you've done your 12 poses, you're going to find first position, your hands are going to come up, and you are going to scratch like a mouse really fast. Good. And now, as I'm scratching, your legs start to plie, because as soon as the music comes on, we have two pas de chats. Remember, step of the cat. So we go pas de chat, pas de chat, and then we turn around really fast. Can you do that again? Ready? Pasha, pasha, and turn around really fast. And then this is the part where the mice are trying to find Marie. So let's point this way. No, maybe she went that way. I don't know, but let's be really sneaky and tiptoe around. Let's try those pashas again, friends. Ready? First position. Mice hands up. We scratch. Now we pasha. We go one, two. Turn around, one, two, turn around. We point, and we turn around. Good, let's pasha again. One, two, turn around. One, two, turn around. We point, and then we tiptoe really quietly now. This is where we find Marie, and we want to sneak up on her and scare her, okay? So, looking towards Marie, we lift our legs up four times, really big. One, two, three, four. We prance with little steps. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. After eight, we jump up, we scare Marie, and we tiptoe back, and we finish in our favorite mouse pose. Ready, friends? Let's give it a try.